Hi, this is George Lees, analysing what is a religious video made by the papal descendant that is James Corden, who is part of the piss take team for Piso, and that is the first Piso Popes and the naming of him in that line that includes the Bishop of Rome that never lived, that was St. Peter. All of them are nicknames for Arius Copernicus Piso, and the Flavians that followed on from him have become the world owners through all of that world time, even although they're named as different dynasties, and all of it is a massive steal. They own the whole world, and Corden knows that he's from those families. So what he's doing here is taking the Arsenal football team, which is the story about Arsenal is the name of the Arsenoe are the Egyptian pharaoh bloodlines above Mark Antony and Cleopatra, who was in the 7th Arsenoe dynasty, and that is the Gunnersbury place for Rothschild. That is the stadia that has now become the it's named after the Arabs, yeah, because they are descended from the pharaohs. And when my wife took me to the church in Chipping Norton on Christmas Eve, all the Arsenal players were lined up in front of me, and the dark centre forward that was the England player, I think he was Peter someone, I forget what his name is, but they were all sat in front of me, and her and her in-laws pointed out to me that they were the Arsenal players, and I had no idea what that meant at that time, because I was still looking for jobs as a professor of neuroscience. That's Chipping Norton that launched the Windrush scandal a few days ago, and when I used to look for, when I realised that Arsenoe and that bloodline, that is the Soters of Egypt, and that is Anne Souter and her brother, Anne Gloag and her brother Brian Souter, they are descended from the Egyptian pharaohs, which is why they have the biggest bus empire in the world, and Aristobus is one of their ancestors, and they are it is the whole of the Piso Windsor Bush bloodline that is being laughed at here. And when the Arsenal fans used to, and I wish I'd made a video of it at the time, when Arsene Wenger, he's just packed up, because my story is becoming to be whispered on every street corner, yet that is Arsene Wenger of that same bloodline, a Frenchman allegedly, and that is the massive influence that the French have had on religion, and the fact that Charlemagne lived in Casino in France, and that's why all those Casino movies were made. And in the old days they had a player in the team for Arsenal that had his hair up in a bun, that's the pineapple on his head, and they used to chant at him, and that's the pineapple, and the pyramids that are on the graves of Taze Russell, of the Russell Group Mafia that now runs the university rankings and the Tavistock Mind Control Institutes as the Dukes of Bedford and of Exeter and Exmouth, which are Xmas in the False Jesus story, and launched there by St. Boniface. Okay, so it's taken me ages to find another reference to, sorry, to find another reference to the Piso pineapple on an Arsenal supporter or player's head. All of the fans used to chant it en masse behind the goals as they went in their tournaments all over the world, and they used to have the gun for Gunnersbury on, and that's the Rothschild home, yeah. The world owning bloodline, and Arsene Wenger is in it. which is why he's retired recently. So I'm now going to press the button and get this to play, and there he's talking to a swimmer, and all of the folk that are playing for them now are descended from those same bloodlines. All of them are aristocrats of world history, and they're the richest people in the world because of their capacity to boot the sun god Sol Natalis Invictus around the pitch. And that is the winners of the Ballon d'Or are the best football players in the world. And Lionel Messi of Barcelona has won that four times now. And he is related to Shimon Perez of Israel. And the Perezes are related to the Percys of Alnwick. And the Percys of Alnwick, through Barbara Pierce, are related to George W. Bush, and on it goes. And that, in football mad Latin America, is the killing by the CIA from America using the military regime that became Pinochet, who died in one of Mrs. Thatcher's beds in London. Yeah, it is a massive syndicate, and this is the only mention of pineapple that I can find in Arsenal's story. Now, the chant was, he's got a pineapple on his head, he's got a pineapple on his head. Yeah, and every one of the Arsenal fans used to sing it. There were videos on the internet, yeah, of parties in people's houses with all the Arsenal colours and them waving the flag side to side as they sing it. And the player that they sang it for was one of their famous strikers, and he had the little hair up icon on the back of his head. That the Welshman who scored the magnificent goal in the final still wears, that is the Piso bun and the icon for you being in their lineages. Gareth Bale, I think his name is, and that is yeah. So Smithy is one of those people that I've already declared is in Gavin and Stacy. That covers up the Jack the Ripper murders. It covers up the fact that their married name in Gavin and Stacy is Shipman, and that is all the Shipman serial killers. The real Shipman was Tim Shipman. Yeah, that's the Harold Shipman was the serial killer in the NHS, and Tim Shipman was the war correspondent for Iraq. Same joke as Mr. Bean. So now let me... Smithy made this. I'm not sure when it was made. It's got 6 million views, and this is False Religion, and they're in Los Angeles, which is the holy city, and is the most quake-prone place in the world. That's God's earthquakes. And these are the people that have written the gods out of the earthly story. Yeah, those are the heavenly creators of our universe, and they're all laughed at by the humans. And that is the Ballon d'Or that was originally won by the Blackpool Tower hero that was Stanley Mathews. Yeah, that's the Ballon d'Or, which is the sun god Sol that they boot around. And that's why the Harry Enfield movies on Arsenal playing against Liverpool have been,
that thing, there's no eyes,
been taken down off the internet. Yeah, that's them kicking the sun god Sol and then misinterpreting all of the rules and taking the piss out of Liverpool players cuddling their colleagues when they score a goal, and all of that has been taken off the internet, like every one of the pineapple videos. Yeah, and that's them now interrupting my presentation of this through the Putlocker scam. That is another joke about Piso and the pen for Piso. That is Bic Putlocker, and the name of a town in northern Italy, for the Pauline missions that took religion all over the world and killed every pagan. Yeah, it's quite sensitive really, and that's why they were in Chipping Norton, in that church, knowing that I'm going to take this job on. I did not know anything about the Piso fraud at that time. Still trying to be a successful professor of neuropharmacology and how the brain works for tiny-minded people like this one.
Team, and I say no, there isn't, but there is me.
Come on, Jackaroo, here we go, I'm Kieran. All right, here we go. Great session, guys, here we go.
And if you put me in the team, you'll get results.
All right, guys, welcome to the training session. We'll start and we'll just warm up. We'll just warm up, okay? So we'll just open the gate. Open the gate, yeah? Open the gate. Grab the pineapple. Grab.
So the fish is the penis, and grabbing the pineapple, not sure what they're trying to depict it as there, but those are the limbs of the swastika. Yeah, and all of it is the same Gunnersbury jokes that mean that Gunnersbury has had to be demolished because of the association with an arsenal, which is the place where you keep your weapons. Yeah, and it's now the Emirates Stadium for the emirs and the oil-rich people that still finance the bringing down of the Twin Towers and went to the same school as Rothschild and Kaiser Bill, that is La Rosie in Switzerland.
Grab the pineapple, grab the pineapple. Now let's just loosen up the hips, back the other way. And then just relax, work. Just twerk it. Is it worth it? Let me work it. I put my game down, flip it and reverse it. Yeah?
You know what was amazing was I'm working with these players who are, you know, these players are paid hundreds of thousands of dollars every week and they're looking at each other and thinking, I've never been happier than this moment.
That's it. I mean, ultimately, this is all, for me, quite basic stuff. Let's see what we got. Good finish. But for a lot of these lads, they've never really done training.
So that was West Ham's jersey. That's Martin Peters and all the people that were heroes in the World Cup final. And Hurst is a famous religious name. Yeah, and that is the Austrian nobility naming. I forget what the name, they're Fursts back then. One letter is completely unimportant. It is an ancient historic joke, and almost all the families are out of aristocratic Austria, and I've explained that again and again and again, and he's one of the most evil people in the world, which is why he takes the piss out of everything, and they defy the gods in its most in their most earthquake prone city in America. Okay, I'm just going to play it a little bit more in case.
Exercises like this before. Jeez.
I've seen that show where he talks to people, but I don't know why they give him the right to try and talk to us about football.
Oh! Made him look a fool!
I think he looks more like a footballer than he is a football coach.
That's what I'm saying. Good effort. Football's about communication, right?
So I don't know what that means, but it may think like me that there may be more than one God. Yeah, and that is the Ballon d'Or for Stanley Mathews of Blackpool.
It's not just about you, it's about the ball. David, what's the ball saying to you right now? Shut your eyes. Really hear the ball. Do you know what I can hear it saying? David doesn't like me. He's scared of me. Keep me close. Protect me. Love me. Why don't you give him a kiss? That's it. He said, I'm even quicker than you. Why can't you chase me? Go, chase him. Go, chase him.
So that is one of the richest men on the world for his capacity to be a religious buffoon. You get it? That is the Piso bloodline that created the Bible, that wrote the whole thing, wrote in all the myths that we now swear to, And that is everything we have to pay for: our christening, yeah, our marriage, and our funeral. All of it is a Piso money stream, and all of the families, yeah, they're brazen about it. That's why it's taken so long for me to get Arsene Wenger out of the job. Yeah, and he's got a pineapple. So let me take it back and show you what I got as hits for "He's Got a Pineapple on His Head." That's the search terms I used, are Arsenal fans, pineapple on his head. You used to get half a dozen videos, just the ordinary fans and punters doing it. Yeah, and that's what I got. There is not one video on that theme now. And I forget what the name of the player was. There he is. Jason Lee gets his own back. Oh, maybe there's... This would be perfect.
Did he get you back on the telly the other day, sort of? Did this for this?
Well, funnily enough, here's a clip of Jason's story. Well, if you watch him afterwards, I think he might be trying to tell us something.
He's got a pineapple on his head. Yeah, and there were dozens of videos.
Do you think Jason's got better recently? Because we think he has.
Yeah.
We think he has. No, seriously. We've got a distinction. We
stop beating your wife, is one of.
And this is what they do. All of these are elite family bloodlines, European aristocrats, Austrian nobility, yeah, German archdukes. It's amazing. Yeah, and all of them live on, and all of them become the Forbes rich listers. And that's a Skinner, and he's like Mickey Skinner. It's stunning. They are all Illuminati. Anyway, that's a term that gets demonised a lot. I just wonder if there's a little glimpse of the song at the end.
No, we wrote him a letter actually. We did, yes. We said, "Dear Jason,
yeah,
come on,
yeah,
we come on."
And he hasn't sent us one back. Apparently, he tried to, but he couldn't quite get it in the mailbox.
Yeah. Look, we try and pick like clips for this show. We saw this one clip, and for a second, this is true, we actually thought that Frank Clark had a Jason Lee haircut, right? But unfortunately, we realised it was a mistake. But look, it was so close. Look.
So that is the pyramids. That is the Egyptian pharaohs and the naming of Arsenal from the Arsenal bloodline. No one dare sing that song again. And just to conclude, I'll show you Arsene Wenger and his farewell speech. Oh, Arsene Wenger song. Yeah, they've got all sorts of covers for it. This will not be the pineapple song. Brilliant new Arsene Wenger song, chant. Yeah, all of it has replaced the story that I've just told you. And it's really quite dangerous to mess with the gods in Los Angeles. Lionel Messi. Okay, let's see whether or not this is the Arsenal pineapple song. Everything is a cover-up. Arsene Wenger, let's just see what he looks like and what he said when he retires. T- 28 minutes long and there will...
Mark Lawrence's face resembles a melting candle. Well, it does this week because I've just been to my house in Mallorca.
Called London 2012.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Alex Scott.
So they're still allowed to chant Arsenal, but they're not allowed to chant. He's got a pineapple on his head now. Yeah, and Arsene is a giveaway. I wish I could see an image of him.
So for time to finish by one simple word, I will miss you.
I doubt the gods will miss them. Yeah, Los Angeles, here you come. Okay, so that is Arsene Wenger of the Arsenoe Pharaoh bloodlines. And let me show you that on the front page of my website, just before we stop. Yeah, there's the Arsenal jersey and the pie Piso pineapple joke, and there it is. Exemplified Gunnersbury, Philip of Macedonia, Lagos the Rabbit, Ptolemy Souter, that's Brian Souter's bloodline of Stagecoach. Yeah, there is Arsenal, Marries a Concubine, Ptolemy, Philadelphia, yeah, Eugertes, Marries Berenice, Ptolemy, Philopater the Fourth, Marries Arsenal. Isn't it lovely? And there's Jeff Merson wetting his beak, and all of it is the mafia history. Nathan Mayer Rothschild's Gunnersbury, the former name of their stadium and the Rothschild mansion. Yeah, okay. And Jeff Merson then became a money launderer, and I met him several times. I can't remember where it was, and he still commentates for the powers that be today. And there is, right at the top of the world-owning bloodline, Philip of Macedonia, and Alexander the Great, and Roxana the prostitute, the red light district that is Soho, that has been shut down by the Coens, who are the daughters of the Coens that are the launch of Tesco, and the Tedesco families from Austria. The master racers are here. Anyway, let's turn off the video. He got a pineapple on his head, and that's what Jeff Merson has there. And in those days, maybe even in the video that I made on that, there might be a reference to that. Have a look at that page on my website. Look up 100 acre Bearwood. KP, you don't need to put all those terms in. The search engine is up on the top right hand corner. And do you get it? Anyway, that last bit will be humming. And that is the King Herod of that same bloodline, who was in Rome helping launch the global project that is globalism, and planting the notion that Jesus ever lived into people's heads. And that is the basis for false religion. And every one of the Arsenal fans will not be able to look their maker in the eye, because they continue pretending that Jesus and St. Peter and the whole of the Piso nicknames are actually people who ever lived on this earth. And there's the people that were Jamesy Souter in the Rabsy Nisbet comedy. And that's the world's elites. And there is Winston Churchill making the... bunny symbol. Lagos, the rabbit of Macedonia, married Alexander the Great, and then they launch the Soters and the Arsenoes into the Queen of England's bloodline, and the Roosevelt bloodline, and the Bush bloodline, and the killing of everything that moves in Latin America by those military regimes. Let's stop that now.